direction. So Syracuse, a little bit of snow right now, and right in the Buffalo area as we get the eastern tip of Lake Erie here. Honing in a little bit closer, Oswego County could pick up some heavy amounts. We're talking as much as perhaps a foot before all is said and done. And look at this persistent band crossing right over the central parts of Lake Erie. There is Erie, Pennsylvania, just to the east of that heavier band. And off of Lake Michigan here, the southeastern lake shores and the southwestern parts of the lower peninsula of Michigan, south and west of Grand Rapids, that's where we have some of the heaviest snow. So here you have it, all of the lake effect snows that we're finding right now. But believe it or not, we have another clipper system that will be swinging through, and that's going to enhance the snow even more as we look at the latter part of the week into the weekend. So the heavy snows that we're finding now just from the pure lake effect event, and then the enhanced lake effect snow. So yes, there you have it, as much as a foot in some cases where we have those persistent bands. Of course, we will keep you updated with the final lake effect snow totals by the end of the weekend. Back to you, Jennifer.
Looks like we're gonna need to break that shovel out. We'll still to come on Weather Center Live. We'll explain how the body responds to all this Arctic air, including important warning signs you need to watch when you're out in the elements. Plus, how about a live look at Dallas? Dallas, right now, it actually feels like 40, or should say 26 degrees. Wind gusts right now at 40 miles per hour. Tomorrow, you'll be 20 degrees below average. Get ready for the chill.
There's a hot offer for heartburn sufferers. Now try Zantac free at ZantacOffers.com. Hurry, it's free this week only. No pill relieves heartburn faster. Get Zantac free at ZantacOffers.com.
Huh, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Yeah, everybody knows that.
Well, did you know that playing cards with Kenny Rogers gets old pretty fast?
You got to know when to hold 'em, know when to fold 'em. Know when to walk away, know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. What? You get it?
No. I get the gist, yeah. Okay.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
This is Paul. This is Paul's office. For those who believe a serious job doesn't have to feel so serious. One a day men's VitaCraves with key nutrients like B vitamins, which help convert food to fuel. It's not just a gummy. It's a complete multivitamin.
Welcome back. Big news from Beverly Hills. Celebrity plastic surgeon Dr. Andrew Orton has discovered an anti-aging breakthrough called Fill and Freeze. And he's giving away 1 million bottles free.
I've spent nearly 30 years looking for an effective, instant breakthrough to reduce the appearance of wrinkles that can be applied topically instead of with surgery or invasive medical techniques. And I finally found it with Derm Exclusives Fill and Freeze.
Wow, I'm young again. I don't feel like an old lady. The lines are gone.
Oh my God, wow. I can't believe it. It looks really good. It gives you a whole new confidence.
It definitely took 10 years off. If I went to a dermatologist here in the city, I would pay $300, $400 for this.
I know you're wondering what Derm Exclusive can do for you. Well, you don't have to wonder. You can order it right now and try it for yourself absolutely risk-free. And here's how.
Call now during this special direct-to-consumer offer and you won't pay $120. Today, you can get your own instant results with Fill and Freeze for only $59. But that's not all. Today, we're taking another $20 off, so now you can get this instant wrinkle-removing miracle for the low price of only $39.95. And as part of our 1 million bottle giveaway, Dr. Orton is including a second $60 bottle of Fill and Freeze free. That's nearly $120 of Fill and Freeze for only $39.95. Dr. Orton will even include his micropeel resurfacing pads, intensive repair serum, and collagen lift moisturizer, a $200 value, free. Order now and we'll even upgrade your order to express delivery. That's a $15 value, free. Plus, you even get to try it risk-free for 30 days with our money-back guarantee. But you must call to order. Call 1-800-730-7432. That's 1-800-730-7432. Order now.
This winter, you've got to watch the Weather Channel mornings.
It's going to have wide-ranging impacts.
Winter storms are too important to cover in just a few minutes.
It's going to be brutal for a lot of people.
Because it's not just about your forecast.
That's why those temperatures stay cold.
Look at this!
Listen to that!
See this winter like never before. Amazing starts here. the Weather Channel Mornings.
Currently in our area, 76 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, high 78, winds northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, low 53. Thursday, mostly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, high 67. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Camera.
Oh my God.
Tonight, tomorrow night, every weeknight, wild weather at 8 on the Weather Channel.
So do you think you can escape the Arctic chill? Well, you better book a ticket to South Florida or the West Coast. Here's a look at just how much of the country will drop below freezing. You see that white line there? That's the freezing line. We're going to see it in areas like Tallahassee, and it's going to stretch all the way through the Gulf of Mexico. Even our friends in Mexico are going to be looking at that. Hace frío.
Hace frío.
Yeah, okay. Cold. No. Cold in Mexico. All right, well, hello and thanks for watching Weather Center Live. I'm Jennifer Delgado.
And I'm Vivian Brown. Now, we are talking 20 degrees below average for the eastern half of the country. The most dangerous temperatures will be across the Midwest.
That's right. And our coverage of this Arctic chill continues right now with expert analysis from storm specialist Carl Parker. Carl, break down the chilly numbers for us.
Hace frío, indeed. It's exceptionally cold right now in the northern plains and will be for a long time to come. And let's take a look at the satellite picture, and you notice this big U-shaped feature in the upper wind right through here. So that's what the upper wind is doing. That's the jet stream right there. And it's not that the jet stream drives the cold plunges, it's rather that they act in concert with one another. Cold air is really the dividing line, or the jet stream rather, is really the dividing line between polar air and much more moderate air. And when you see that big plunge like that, you know you've got a huge intrusion of very cold air. So let's take a look at the visible satellite picture as well. And really interesting shot here. You notice that there is a lot of snow cover there across the lakes and back and into the Midwest, that area of white that's not really moving very much, just getting brighter as the sun comes up. And that too helps to keep these air masses very cold. So that's a big part of what's going on. You also very clearly see that northwesterly flow, the wind driving down and across the mountains. And just as we saw yesterday, we're seeing a large area of wave clouds that has come off of the Appalachians, where you've got an up and down motion in the atmosphere, and right along those little ridge crests, we're getting the development of clouds, just beautiful wave clouds there in a very windy, cold day, up and down 81 in western parts of Virginia. So the wind chills right now, minus 28 Minneapolis, minus 22 in Bismarck, and minus 22 in Chicago. And this is where we're going to be right through the end of this week. Not a lot of change. The wind will let up a little bit, but not a tremendous amount. And then tomorrow morning, we start at 11. That's minus 16 as compared to average in D.C. We start at 12 in Oklahoma City and 18 in Charleston. That's minus 19 as compared to average. And we're looking at possible record lows in a lot of different locations, at 20, for example, Pensacola, the forecast, and certainly could be a new record there along the Gulf Coast as a result. Now, in the longer term, you've got this big plunge of cold air coming down right through here. In the longer term, we're going to watch this ridge break down, and we're going to watch this area of cold air, that big dip in the jet stream, that's going to retreat, and we'll get another little area of cold coming across the lakes. But then by the weekend, we see more of a westerly component to the wind and a definitive moderating trend. Now, it's not going to get really warm, but it's going to warm up some. And in fact, here is the European model temperature forecast. You notice temperatures do finally make it to above average by the middle of January. So there is some relief on the way. Viv, Jen, back to you.
All right. Thanks very much, Carl. You know, the big danger during this bitter cold weather is the wind chill. And if you're not protected against it, frostbite can set in very quickly.
And it's a big worry for parents and school officials. because kids, of course, are waiting at the bus stop and they are the most vulnerable. Meteorologist Alex Wallace is here with us today to break down some of the important warning signs out there. You know, really, you want to bundle up the kids and you want them to look like the kid in The Christmas Story.
You just
don't want to see their face like Ralphie's a little brother.
It's so true. Everyone's seen that movie, so we all know what it's supposed to look like, right? But it's so true. It can be very dangerous, and this is something we'll be watching over the next day or two with this extreme cold that is in place out there for us. Check it out right now. Look at these numbers. This is what it feels like out there. I mean, just incredible. 30 degrees below zero in Minneapolis International Falls, the icebox of the U.S., 34 degrees below zero. Again, these are what it feels like, the numbers out there. Nashville feels like it's 8. So you start talking numbers well below zero like that and you're out there for prolonged periods, it can get very dangerous and can lead to issues like frostbite. Of course, frostbite being basically the freezing of the skin and the tissue underneath that skin, and that could lead to some big problems out there for you. So let's talk about it here. And again, it's all caused by prolonged exposure to very, very cold temperatures out there. So what happens is the body's first response is to protect the organs that are inside of us, things like the heart, the lungs out there for you, by cutting circulation to the extremities, things like your fingers, your toes, your ears. So when that happens, you don't get blood flowing to these areas. They eventually end up freezing. So what do you need to look for? What are some of the symptoms out there for you? Well, cold skin with a bit of a prickly feeling out there for you, almost like when your foot falls asleep. Feels like that out there. Numbness and also discolored skin. And you can also find yourself dealing with clumsiness because the joints and muscles become very, very stiff. And also, one thing you want to watch out for is even after you rewarm, blistering can occur and permanent changes in sensation. And in severe cases, this is where we really get into problems, amputation. Of course, we've got cold air coming into parts of the South, so we got to protect ourselves, right, Jen?
That's right. You gave all those great tips out there, and we want to warn you, the coldest air is going to be felt by tomorrow morning. It's really going to be a shock to your system, and it's going to be across parts of the South. We are not going to dodge it. In fact, we have hard freeze warnings in place, you can see, for Louisiana all the way down towards Florida. Wind chill advisories for Atlanta if you're in the blue there, because you're going to be feeling blue with the strong winds out there. Tomorrow morning lows, 5 degrees in Nashville, 23 degrees below average. At the freezing, or should say 0 degrees in Louisville, 10 in Chattanooga, Atlanta, 13 degrees for you, your overnight low. Friday, we get a little bit better out there, but notice that we are still below average in some of these locations, 10 to 12 degrees below where they should be for this time of the year. We talk about the area that's going to see the very southernmost tip that's going to be looking at temperatures waking up right in the single digits. That is actually Highland Lake. That is actually just to the north of Birmingham, roughly about 30 miles or so. Atlanta, we're looking at 13 degrees for you. And for Louisville, here's your forecast. Thursday a.m., 3 degrees. And then we slowly warm things up. But by Saturday, another round of that cold air with 12 degrees for your morning low. At least it's Saturday. Try to sleep in a little bit later. Over to you, Viv.
Well, you know what, Jennifer? This cold blast can be big business, especially if you're, say, in the home heating business. The freezing temperatures are putting furnaces to the test. And house calls from the repairman aren't free. Dave Malkoff explains how you can avoid having to bundle up inside your own home.
Sure, it's beautiful, but remember, it's brutally cold here in the Chicago suburbs. You shouldn't have to wear all this winter gear inside your home. That should be your sanctuary. But that's not the case for tons of people who woke up this morning with an emergency call to the heater repairman.
I'm just calling to let you guys know I'm heading out there.
The phone calls haven't stopped all day. In some cases, this is the first real test for furnaces all over the Midwest. And some aren't burning as blue as they used to.
Oh, yeah, you can see the flame down there, too.
Yeah.
Pretty cool.
Despite that, it has been bitter cold in Nick Drouse's home.
It stays warmer around in the hallway area and by the washroom. Okay. But then when you venture over here, a lot with the open windows and everything or sliding doors.
Yeah, you can feel the temperature drop right here.
Yeah, it gets a little colder.
Many older homes around here don't have the kind of windows that keep the winter outside, leaving Nick feeling like a snowman here at night.
Sweaters and sweatpants at times.
You're sleeping in sweaters and sweatpants because it's so cold in your bedroom?
Yeah.
Back in the basement, the diagnosis is in.
It looks like the pilot did come on.
Sam Adicio from Topline Heating says that older burner has seen better days. And it's at least $2,000 to swap it out, maybe $5,000 for a high-end model.
You gotta pay the price sometimes, I guess.
It gets cold in Chicago.
Yep. Yes, it does. Very cold.
And maybe this advice falls into the better late than never category, but it's always best to have a little bit of maintenance in the fall than that emergency call right in the middle of a big winter storm. In Chicago, Dave Malkoff, The Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, high 78, winds northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, low 53. Thursday, mostly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, high 67. Here's our 7-day outlook. Sometimes at last doesn't happen at first.
My love has come along. My lonely days.
Hey, Dad, just kiss my mom.
Are over.
Turning two worlds into one takes love.
And life is like a song.
Helping protect that world takes State Farm.
Shopping online is as easy as it gets. Wouldn't it be great if hiring plumbers, carpenters, and even piano tuners were just as simple? Thanks to Angie's List, now it is. We've made hiring anyone from a handyman to a dog walker as simple as a few clicks. Buy their services directly at AngiesList.com. No more calling around. No more hassles. Start shopping from a list of top-rated providers today.
Angie's List is revolutionizing local service again. Visit AngiesList.com today.
Oh, there's an energy crisis happening, all right. A human one. And it's time to fight it. With the good energy of Quaker Oats. It's how we help keep go-getters like you going and getting. One bite at a time. Try new Quick Steel Cut Oatmeal for a heartier texture. Quaker Up.
I have a cold with terrible chest congestion. Better take something.
Theraflu Severe Cold doesn't treat chest congestion.
Really?
New Alka-Seltzer Plus Day Powder rushes relief to your worst cold symptoms plus chest congestion.
Oh, what a relief it is.
Here we go!
Today's grocery bags leave a lot to be desired. They dig into your hands when you carry them. They spill open when you're driving. And they're so small, unloading them requires endless trips back and forth to your car. You need a better solution. You need a grab bag. You'll start loving your grab bag the minute you reach the checkout aisle. Because it grabs onto your card and stays open, you can easily fill it after items are scanned. Then when you get to the car, they simply lift out and go right in your trunk. And it gets even better. Grab bags have a broad base and a securing flap, so they sit up nicely in the back of your car and won't spill all over while you're driving home. Plus, they expand to hold several times what a regular shopping bag can hold. Amazing! Imagine being able to grab and go in a single trip. Ever had something heavy rip right out of a plastic bag and smash on the ground? Not with a grab bag. Even this heavy dumbbell is no match for its super sturdy construction, and that's a lot more weight than most people will ever need to carry. Grab bags are made of earth-friendly material that's mold and mildew resistant. They easily wipe clean with just a damp cloth. Even better, they fold flat when you're done, so you can store them in your kitchen or in your car. Every grab bag even has a generous front pocket with plenty of room for wallets, coupons, even cell phones. Use them at the laundromat or even on picnics and trips to the beach. Call now, and through this special TV offer, you'll get two grab bags for just $14.99. They come with a full 1-year money-back guarantee. Call or click in the next 5 minutes and get absolutely free shipping and handling. And find out about our incredibly low price on our deluxe insulated grab bag. Use it to keep frozen food from defrosting, or use it to keep hot food ready to eat when you get home. Get two grab bags with free shipping and handling and exclusive pricing on our insulated grab bag for just $14.99. Call now.
Call 1-800-566-6075 to get the grab bag special on this TV offer. But you must call to order or go online to grabbag.com.
So call 1-800-566-6075. That's 1-800-566-6075. Call now.
This is just too hard for me to process. Could you imagine living in a place where the sun never came up? Well, since November 18th, people in Barrow, Alaska have been living in the dark. I mean, that's just gotta be plain miserable.
Well, let me tell you, they will stay in the dark at least until January 23rd because the sun won't even rise above the horizon until then.
You know, people live out in Alaska because they love the outdoors, the wilderness, and they love the snow, but I know they love to see that sunshine as well.
All right, well, here's more details in this edition of Brainstorm with our own Sam Champion.
Barrow, Alaska, the northernmost town in the United States. It sits over 300 miles north of the Arctic Circle. Its remote location exposes it to some of the most extreme conditions of any populated area on the planet, including about 65 days a year of near total darkness. This Arctic darkness is caused by the 23.4 degree tilt of the Earth's axis. Because of this, each pole spends half a year facing away from the sun. Beginning with the autumn equinox in late September, the sun sets at the North Pole. By the time we get to the winter solstice in late December, the entire region above 66 degrees north sees no sun at all. With Barrow situated at 71 degrees north, their Arctic darkness stretches between November and January. This prolonged absence of sunlight is one reason temperatures can drop below minus 30 degrees in Barrow. And with an average wind speed of 12 miles per hour, during the extended darkness, the wind chill can reach minus 55 degrees. And that's about 80 degrees lower than the average temperature on the moon and can cause frostbite in as little as 5 minutes. And living in nonstop darkness can also disturb the body's circadian rhythms. Normally, the level of melatonin, the hormone that governs our sleep, is lowest in the morning and peaks late at night. But during Arctic darkness, melatonin production can surpass even the highest normal levels by as much as 30%. As a result, if you live in Barrow, Alaska, it's not unusual to feel drowsy during the day for more than 2 months at a time. And you've been Brainstormed. Sam Champion, The Weather Channel.
All right, now we know. Let's check out the next 7 days of weather to see how things will change, because our big story is definitely the Arctic invasion. It's covering at least two-thirds of the eastern half of the eastern two-thirds of the country. Here's a look at today. Caught up in that cold, we also have the lake effect snow machine. It's on and it's cranking right off of Lake Michigan all the way to the eastern Great Lakes, and locally heavy amounts, of course, where those persistent bands will be. But the general rule will be the extremely cold air today, but I'll tell you what, it will get colder overnight tonight and tomorrow. Look at tomorrow's high, barely getting above freezing for the Atlanta area, 33 degrees. And again, keep in mind that the morning low waking up tomorrow will be extremely frigid, 39 in Dallas, the forecast high tomorrow, about 43 in Denver and 49 in Seattle. But as you can see, barely do we find any spots of 70s, and certainly not many 80s. Don't even find an 80 anywhere on this map. Here's a look at the forecast for Friday. Now, as we head into the weekend, we'll begin to see some moisture increasing along the Gulf Coast. Now, as this moisture increases and it meets up with the cold air, we could be talking about some icy conditions in parts of Texas, Oklahoma, Arkansas, and southern Missouri, and then all of this moisture spreads east. We think it will be an all-rain event for you, Atlanta. A chilly rain, though, because highs will only be in the low 50s, but maybe on the extreme northern fringes of that, we're looking at icy conditions and some snow back maybe in the New York City area, light snow. And here's a look at the forecast for Tuesday as we watch another system coming down the pike here, this one coming out of the Pacific Northwest and takes a dive southward. Denver, maybe some snow for you on Tuesday, and looking at perhaps another round of ice in Texas. We'll keep you updated.
If you're driving and you can't see clearly for 1 second at 60 miles per hour, you can't see clearly for 88 feet. And a lot can happen in 88 feet. That's why Bosch created the new Icon with ClearMax 365. It's a rubber technology for longer lasting performance, not found on any other wiper blade. Because like you, Bosch cares about what's ahead.
Sheila, you see this ball control? You see this, right? It's 80% confidence and 64% knee brace.
That's much.
I know that's more than 100%, but that's what winners give. Now bicycle kick your old 401k into an IRA.
I know.
Listen, just get TD Ameritrade's rollover consultants on the horn. They'll guide you through the whole process. It's simple. Even she could do it. Whatever, Janet.
For all the confidence you need, TD Ameritrade, you got this.
Golf's past two decades have been the most unique in the history of the game. Now, in a commemorative edition, Golf Channel chronicles the icons, the moments, and the trends that will influence the game for decades to come. Just in time for the holiday season, the Golf Book is the perfect gift for every golfer on your list. Order yours today at golfchannel.com/thegolfbook.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, high 78, winds northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, low 53. Thursday, mostly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, high 67. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Totino's Pizza Rolls get you there in just 60 seconds. Go bold with flavors that kick.
Every truck can tow a boat. Every truck can climb a hill. Every truck can haul a trailer. But not everyone can say they're the fastest growing truck brand in America. Guts, glory, Ram.
Stop by your neighborhood Ace and we'll help you get organized. 18-gallon totes, $3.99 after $1 instant savings.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
Sir, we're going to need you on the runway.
Theraflu starts to get to work in your body in just 5 minutes. Theraflu breaks you free from your worst cold and flu symptoms. Theraflu, serious power.
I thought it would be fun, so I went on Ancestry.com, and this little leaf gave me a hint, and that led me to another leaf and another hint. I was like the family detective. Then I found out that one of my ancestors actually was a detective. So I'm like the other family detective.
Visit Ancestry.com and discover the world's largest online family history resource.
FAU's Lifelong Learning Society in Jupiter is a great place to learn something new. It offers affordable university-level courses for adults of all ages with no homework, no tests, and no stress. There are one-day lectures or 4, 6, and 8-week courses. Course and lecture topics are taught all year round and include a variety of liberal arts subjects. Take only the courses you want, then sit back, relax, and enjoy. Visit us online to learn more and start your tomorrow today.
Spend Valentine's Day with Broadway's Sexiest Man. On Saturday, February 14th at the Parker Playhouse, spend one night with Cheyenne Jackson during a gala to benefit Stonewall National Museum and Archives, the nation's largest LGBT museum. Help support Stonewall Museum and Archives by purchasing tickets through stonewall-museum.org or by calling 954-763-8565.
Car insurance in a whole new light. Liberty Mutual Insurance.
Ride on the most treacherous highway in the world to experience the high risk of heavy rescue. Highway Through Hell, Sundays at 10 on the Weather Channel.
A live look at Buffalo, New York. Now, the city and surrounding areas got hit hard by lake effect snow back in November. Now, today, highs in the single digits and some light snow showers in the forecast. Already, we've had a couple of inches, but on the south side, as you head down to Dunkirk, they've had almost a half a foot. Another lake effect snow happening right now, but it looks like Buffalo will dodge pretty much the worst of it.
A storm specialist, Carl Parker, is in the lab with our winter weather update. Now, Carl, we're talking still some areas with some big time snow.
Yeah, that's right. What has happened here in the last 12 hours is that we've seen a real big wind shift. And so where the winds were driving snow into Buffalo, now it's pressing down towards the south-southeast. And we'll take a look at that in just a moment. Let's first show you the larger picture, and it's a very chilly one. That is snow all the way down into the Appalachians, the southern Appalachians, into parts of Tennessee. Saw a couple of flurries in the Atlanta metro earlier today. Some snow also in West Virginia and down through North Carolina. And we're going to focus in on the lake effect that is ongoing right now. Now, I'm going to turn the clock back to midnight last night and to 4 a.m. So that little period between midnight and 4 a.m. And at that time, we had winds coming out of the west-southwest, driving a big band into the Tug Hill Plateau, which is north of Syracuse, coming off of Lake Ontario. And we had another band there coming into western parts of New York State. But right at that time, a front was coming down. And behind that front, we had north to northwest winds dropping in. And what they did is they disrupted that band, and then watch what happens. We'll go now from 4 a.m. all the way until now, and you see how the band remained intact largely and was just pushed down to the south. So you've still got a band here in central Pennsylvania. That was the band that developed with that west-southwesterly flow, but now it's being pushed bodily down towards the south, and we've got bands that are coming over a long fetch from parts of Lake Huron down into Lake Erie, and then also up into Lake Superior. So we'll take you down into Erie, Northwest PA, where we've had a pretty good bit of snow in some areas. Still snowing there around Cleveland. It's mostly lighter. And just south and west of Erie in Fairview, we've had 7.5 inches of snow, and there is more on the way. Farther westward, with that north-northwest wind, we've got snow dropping down into northern parts of Indiana. Moderate snow right now in South Bend as well as Valparaiso. And we've also got moderate snow a little farther off towards the north there. And near Benton Harbor, moderate snow now showing up at South Haven as well. And this will go on for a while yet. And then to the north of that, another band dropping down east of Traverse City, and several bands now coming into the UP of Michigan and west of 75. So here's the model forecast. There you see that north-northwesterly flow that we talked about. Watch as that goes away later this week. Another clipper is going to drop down and interrupt that flow. And with that, we get a large area of light snow coming through late on Thursday in the eastern part of the lakes. Then after that comes through, winds switch around to the west-northwest. And once again, the lake effect will kick in. So going through Friday, looking for a pretty good bit of snow here. We're talking about several inches in western parts of Michigan all the way down towards Grand Rapids. Large area of heavy snow there in the western part of New York State, and another area here coming off of Lake Erie. So certainly it's going to continue to be very active in the lee of the lakes. But what about other wintry weather? Here's a look at Saturday, and what we've got is that cold air, that huge area of cold air dominating across the country. Here's the leading edge of the below freezing air, that line right there. We're looking at Saturday afternoon, and then right in here in that gray shading, we've got moisture moving in, and where you see the moisture moving in and over top of that cold air at the surface, that's where you've got potential for freezing and or frozen precipitation, and we think freezing rain rain is going to be a distinct possibility in Texas. That will lift up a little farther to the north, going into overnight Saturday, early Sunday morning, and may lift up farther than that, more towards the Ohio Valley and Mid-Atlantic region early on Monday. But we're still seeing a lot of disagreement amongst the models about what exactly is going to take place. So here's our forecast for the time being. Wintry mix there developing west of the Hill Country. We find more of that on Saturday, and then more of that lifting up and into the Mid-South on Sunday. Ladies, back to you.
All right, well, still to come, a Weather Center Live, the latest on a dangerous Arctic blast that is just blanketing the country.
Yeah, let's take a look at the current temperatures. Already, it is here, as you can see. Temperatures right now, when you factor in the winds, it feels like 30 to 35 degrees below average. Some cold stuff.
Currently in our area, 78 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, high 78, winds northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, low 53. Thursday, mostly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, high 67. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Just cold out there. It is dangerous. Arctic air is dominating two-thirds of the country. Now get this, that includes more than 185 million people. That means just about everybody is going to be touched by this, especially in the south.
Everybody, including parts of the Great Lakes. The snow is piling up here as that lake effect snow machine is cranking, and we are forecasting more than a foot of additional snow in some spots. Hello, and thank you so much for joining us on Weather Center Live. I'm Vivian Brown.
And I'm Jennifer Delgado. The cold air is forcing officials in several states to close schools and open emergency shelters out there. Now, take a look at this. Temperatures people woke up to this morning, they were well below freezing. Look at that. Minus one in Chicago, minus 11 in Bismarck, six in Buffalo, and nine in St. Louis. Hello, that'll get you out
and
wake you up.
I know. That's just half of the story, though, you know. When you factor in the winds, this is what it feels like in St. Louis. Not nine above, but nine below. Okay?
Stay inside.
I'll tell you what.
29 in Des Moines.
Wow.
Those winds are just
Look
brutal
at that.
Out there.
21 below at International Falls in northern Minnesota. You know, it is the wind chills that really make people shiver. 20 to 30 degrees below in some spots, and we are on repeat for tomorrow.
And better wind chills means more of us bundling up. Look at this super dad here. He's got his child bundled up just right with a blanket and all that protective clothes. They're doing all the shoveling there in the Windy City. They are suffering. As I said, you could see that lady there. She's bundled up. We don't want to see anything but your eyes. We need her to get a scarf, but also bundled up. Yeah, exactly. Also bundled up. Meteorologist Mike Bettis in Chicago.
Okay? All right, let's hear from him now.
Here in Chicago, it is our third straight day with temperatures below zero, and it may only get colder from here. Obviously, in these kind of conditions, you have to bundle up as best you can. All the folks that are out here along Michigan Avenue in Chicago doing their best to cover up the head, the toes, the hands, because it's just a matter of truly minutes before frostbite can set in, and you don't want to be caught off guard in these kind of conditions. It's not just us, though. It's also that furry member of the family. A couple of things to worry about with your pets in these kind of conditions is that dehydration can set in. If you have an outdoor pet, you'd like to bring them in this kind of weather, but if they've got a dog bowl that's outside, it can freeze over. They can't get a drink of water, so dehydration can be an issue. Also, just truly, if they're cold outside, especially short-haired animals, or short-haired dogs don't have the protection that a lot hairier dogs might have. And also, on the surface, on the sidewalk, where it's been treated with some ice melt, can be very difficult for dogs to walk in. We caught up with some pet owners and talked about their concerns in these kind of conditions.
It's an English lap, right? For him, it's like the best weather he can dream about.
He's cold. So, we're ready to go back in. This This is the longest we've ever been out in this weather.
It's how long?
Some of the chemicals that we do use on sidewalks to melt that ice can be very harsh on our animals, and the paws of our dogs especially can crack them, can irritate them. And so a lot of pet owners that we've seen in Chicago use the little paw booties, and this will protect their paws from really getting irritated from those chemicals. Or you can use a lanolin solution and just wipe it on their paws before you take them out. Obviously, it's man and beast against this weather. Mother Nature kind of giving us the cold shoulder here in the Midwest. One more day to go of the really cold stuff tomorrow morning here in Chicago, looking for double digits below zero. That's the very latest here from the Windy City. I'm meteorologist Mike Bettis.
And I tell you what, when Mother Nature gives you the cold shoulder, you really get the cold shoulder. Check this out. Widespread cold with these wind chill alerts covering at least half of the country, stretched from the Midwest into the Northeast all the way down to the Gulf of Mexico. Wind chill advisories. Officially now, you're under a wind chill advisory in the Atlanta area over to Columbia, South Carolina. But look at these hard freeze advisories that have been posted all the way down to even New Orleans and the panhandle of Florida. So please protect your plants, vegetation, your pets, and protect yourself for sure. Let's bring in Carl Parker, who gives us more tips on how to protect ourselves from this cold. Carl.
Hey, Viv, a big blast of cold, and we're going to start you off with the infrared satellite picture. I always get a kick out of this because we use this satellite to determine the cloud tops. You see the cloud tops as depicted by the temperatures of the cloud tops. So where you've got the blues and yellows and greens, that's where you've got very cold cloud tops. We know those clouds are taller, and that's where a lot of the weather is. And you can very clearly see the big U shape there. That's the dip in the jet stream that is concordant with this big cold blast. But notice also that a lot of the ground is actually white and bluish. That's because the ground itself is cold enough to actually show up on the infrared satellite. It is as cold as the tops of those clouds. Just an amazingly chilly picture there across a lot of the Midwest and the lakes. And there's the wind chills. Minus 24 now in Minneapolis, minus 21 in Chicago, and 7 is the apparent temperature in Nashville. We'll take the forecast forward through this evening and then into tomorrow morning. It's going to be exceptionally cold tomorrow morning there in Chicago. Now, a wind chill of minus 30, minus 31, something like that, when you go to work tomorrow morning. What does that mean? Well, here is our wind chill chart, and the temperature is going to be around minus 5 in Chicago. The winds probably between 20 to 25 miles per hour. So that gives us that wind chill of minus 29 to minus 30. And when we look at the frostbite times, that corresponds to a frostbite time of 30 minutes. That does not give you a lot of time. And make sure you've got plenty of blankets and extra coats in your car in case you happen to break down. There's a look at the Arctic cold all the way down into the south. 5 degrees in Nashville tomorrow morning. Possible records being set along the Gulf Coast and farther northward as well. So there's the big dip that we talked about in the jet stream, but as we drive westward, we see very strong westerly winds coming across the Pacific. And what they will do is actually begin to break down this big ridge in the west. And as that happens, we're not going to see as much of a dip in the east. It's going to be more of a westerly flow across the country, and that will allow the temperatures to moderate a little bit. So here's the European temperature forecast going out quite a bit for Chicago. And you notice that we get up to near average by the 12th, and then finally get a little above average by the middle of the month. Jen, Viv, back to you.
All right. Thanks very much, Carl. Well, stay with us. We continue to bring you the latest information on this dangerous Arctic blast affecting all of us for the most part.
Yeah, make sure you are staying safe. And we're also talking about how it can affect your health.
Think fixing your windshield is a big hassle? Not with SafeLight. This family needed their windshield replaced, but their daughter's heart was set on going to the zoo. So guess what? I met them at the zoo. Service that fits your schedule. That's another SafeLight advantage.
SafeLight Repair, SafeLight Replace.
Guess what goes really well with eggs? Pillsbury Graham's Biscuits make breakfast even better. Graham's Biscuits make breakfast pop.
You drop 40 grand on a new set of wheels, then wham, a minivan T-bones you. Guess what? Your insurance company will only give you $37,000 to replace it. Depreciation, they claim. How can my car depreciate before its first oil change, you ask? Maybe the better question is, why do you have that insurance company?
With
Liberty Mutual new car replacement will replace the full value of your car. See car insurance in a whole new light. Liberty Mutual Insurance.
Have you ever thought about trying eHarmony? Then we've got something exciting just for you. Our free communication weekend and extended days for New Year's. We're giving away unprecedented access, including sending messages to matches who interest you. Kick off the new year right and really experience eHarmony for free. It's the first step in finding that perfect person for you. Connect for free during this special kickoff.
This winter, you've got to watch the Weather Channel mornings.
It's going to have wide-ranging impact.
Winter storms are too important to cover in just a few minutes.
It's going to be brutal for a lot of people.
Because it's not just about your forecast.
That's why those temperatures stay cold.
Look at this!
Listen to that!
See this winter like never before. Amazing starts here. The Weather Channel mornings.
Currently in our area, 78 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, high 78, winds northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, low 53. Thursday, mostly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, high 67. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Camera.
Oh my God.
Tonight, tomorrow night, every weeknight, wild weather at 8 on the Weather Channel.
You know, there's a more enjoyable way to get your fiber. Try Philips Fiber Good Gummies. They're delicious and a good source of fiber to help support regularity.
These are good.
The tasty side of fiber from Philips.
I know there are a lot of ways to lose weight, and believe me, I've tried them all. And along the way, I've learned a few things. Like, did you know that when you lose just 10 pounds, you'll drop your blood pressure by 5 points? Pre-diabetic, lose 7% of your body weight and lower your risk of diabetes by 58%.
Lose weight fast with Nutrisystem's Fast 5 Plus Kit. Lose 5 pounds in your first week, plus 1 inch off your waist or your money back, guaranteed.
So you can have more energy, sleep better, and reduce your pain. And not just look good, but feel good.
Order your 28-day Nutrisystem plan right now, including Fast 5 Plus. Get 1 week of meals, plus 1 week of energizing shakes and Craving Crusher shakes, free. New food selections, new expert guides. Call now and lock in 2014 prices, and shipping is free.
Do what I did and call Nutrisystem.
Check out our plan for people with type 2 diabetes.
Call 877-699-SIZE now and lose your first 5 pounds fast.
Welcome back to Weather Center Live. Well, we have you covered as we continue to talk about the dangerous cold that is now going to be coming through parts of the South. In fact, it already is for areas like New Orleans, Dallas, as well as in Atlanta. So we need to talk about this big cold spell and how long it's going to last and how low we're going to go. In fact, we have hard freeze warnings in effect. You can see for Louisiana, even into Texas, down towards Florida. That includes you and places like Tallahassee. Temperatures running dangerously cold. Right now, we have numbers in the 50s to the south. But you see that Atlanta, 37 degrees, 14 degrees in Louisville, 27 in Memphis. Well, all that cold air, the blue and purple you're seeing, it's going to be heading down towards the south. Sorry to say, but it's going to be sticking around. And really, by the end of next week, we'll start to see those temperatures returning to more like average. Tomorrow morning, how about these lows? This is going to be the coldest spell out there. This is where we're really going to feel the brunt of it. 13 degrees for Atlanta tomorrow morning. Louisville, sorry, zero for you. 11 in Memphis. These numbers running 25 degrees below average in some of these spots. By Friday, we're going to rebound some, but we're still looking at 8 to 12 degrees below average, 19 in Raleigh, as well as 31 just below freezing in Panama City. You think you live in Florida and you're going to escape all this? No, you're not. We talk about how far south this cold air is going to be in the cities that are going to be looking at the single digits for tomorrow. The area that includes the farthest south, this is Highland Lake. That is just basically to the north of Birmingham. So you have been warned. You know it's going to be cold there. So make sure you have everything protected, including yourself as well. That face, everything you can do. For Montgomery, Alabama, Thursday's record low 15 degrees. We are forecasting 16. We're going to get very close to possibly meeting or breaking that record. For Louisville, 3 for you Thursday morning. And then notice you go right back down Saturday to 12 degrees. And then finally, you climb to the freezing mark by next Wednesday. Vivian, this is certainly some dangerous cold that we don't need to play with.
Well, you know what? Another side effect of this cold, more and more people are getting sick. In fact, take a look at the latest numbers from the Centers for Disease Control. Widespread cases of the flu blanket most of the country, and even the states that's not reporting widespread impacts, we have regional impacts. There is not one state with no activity of the flu. So let's bring in Dr. Sujatha Reddy to help bring in some insight. Dr. Reddy, thank you so much for joining us. A question a lot of viewers are asking, is it true that the flu virus spreads faster in cold and dry conditions like we're seeing right now?
Yeah, and we can't just say because our mother said so, it must be true, right? What happens in the cold weather, we theorize that the immune system in the body does not function as well. You may not be able to fight off the cold and flu virus in cold temperatures as well as you can in warmer temperatures. There's also some theories that the flu and cold virus can actually replicate better when the temperatures are colder. Another reason we think more people get sick in the winter months is when you're indoors a lot, you're around a lot of people who carry germs, but also the dry forced air heat can dry out your mucous membranes, make your nose dry, your throat dry, and make you more vulnerable to the virus getting in that way.
Well, Dr. Reddy, I have one question. Can you give us just one piece of advice? If you had one thing to say to help us prevent getting sick, what would that be?
I'm going to tell you two quick things. Get the flu shot and wash your hands as much as possible, and don't touch your nose, your mouth, your ears if you can avoid it.
Okay, well, speaking of the flu shot, a lot of people are saying that this flu shot this year didn't include a particular strain, so it was ineffective. Is that not the case?
Well, the flu shot has 3 strains in it. The one flu virus did change a bit, but all experts believe the existing flu vaccine will offer you some protection. It's not perfect, but it's still recommended to get it because if you get the flu, it'll be shorter and less severe.
Okay, that is some good advice. Thank you so much, Dr. Reddy. I'm going to get my flu shot and I'm going to wash my hands and wash my hands and wash my hands. Thanks very much. All right, well, stay with us here on the Weather Channel. Still to come, our own Mike Seidel reports from Erie on another round of lake effect snow. We're expecting as much as 10 to 12 inches are possible in some areas. Stay with us.
Hi, this is Connor. Sorry I missed you. I'm either away from my desk or on another call. Please leave a message and I'll get back to you just as soon as I'm available. Thank you for your patience at this busy time.
Join us for stargazing with Discovery at Sea. Enjoy cruises from $4.99 during our 50th anniversary sale. Call your travel consultant or 1-800-PRINCESS. Princess Cruises. Come back new.
My job is so hard on my hands.
The cracks were the worst part.
O'Keefe's Working Hands. Guaranteed relief for dry hands that crack and split.
There was a difference within just minutes of it absorbing into my skin.
Only O'Keefe's has given me the relief that I need.
Learn more at workinghands.com.
Saving and smiling. That's how I start the year. With tons of stuff on rollback, clearance, and more at Walmart. And that really puts a smile on my face.
Thousands of items on rollback and clearance, in-store and online.
Your mom's got your back. Your friends have your back. Your dog's definitely got your back. But who's got your back when you need legal help? We do. We're LegalZoom. And over the last 10 years, we've helped millions of people protect their families and run their businesses. We have the right people on hand to answer your questions, backed by a trusted network of attorneys. So visit us today for legal help you can count on. LegalZoom. Legal help is here.
I am never getting married.
Never.
Guaranteed.
You picked a beautiful ring.
Thank you.
We're never having kids.
come of it here?
We are never moving to the suburbs.
We are never getting one of those. We're never having another kid.
I'm pregnant.
I'm never letting go.
For all the nevers in life, State Farm is there. This winter, you've got to watch the Weather Channel mornings.
It's going to have wide-ranging impact.
Winter storms are too important to cover in just a few minutes.
It's going to be brutal for a lot of people.
Because it's not just about your forecast.
That's why those temperatures stay cold.
Look at this.
When it comes to Medicare, everyone talks about what happens when you turn 65. But really, it's what you do before that counts. See, Medicare doesn't cover everything, only about 80% of Part B medical costs. The rest is on you.
Consider an AARP Medicare Supplement Insurance Plan insured by United Healthcare Insurance Company. Like all standardized Medicare Supplement Insurance Plans, it could really save you in out-of-pocket medical costs. So call now and request this free decision guide. Discover how an AARP Medicare Supplement Plan could go long for you.
Do you want to choose your doctors? Avoid networks. What about referrals?
All plans like these let you visit any doctor or hospital that accepts Medicare patients with no networks and virtually no referrals needed. So call now, request your free guide, and explore the range of AARP Medicare supplement plans.
65 may get all the attention, but now is a good time to start thinking about how you want things to be.
Go long.
300-8335. 1-800-300-8335.
The wildest weather ever caught on camera.
Oh my God.
Tonight, tomorrow night, every weeknight, Wild Weather at 8 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 75 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, high 78, winds northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, low 53. Thursday, mostly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, high 67. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Well, listen to that. Yeah, that's the wind ripping around in Erie, Pennsylvania, adding to the misery as heavy snow poured into Erie earlier this morning. You can see the cars, they seem to be going pretty fast despite the snow out there.
Yeah, pretty dangerous still. Many schools in the area either closed or delayed opening for at least 2 hours due to the lake effect blast and the bitter cold.
Well, more people headed to shelters in Erie, Pennsylvania as temperatures tumbled and snow swirled.
And our own Mike Seidel braved the wind, the snow, and the brutal cold near Interstate 90 earlier today.
First, it was the snow, lake effect snow, and now it's the bitter cold coming into western Pennsylvania and northeast Ohio and upstate New York. This is what they've plowed here in this Shell Station parking lot. But this time last year, they'd already had 6.5 feet of snow. Right now, we're sitting at 42 and change. That's right at average. So the plow operators, after really raking in the cash last year, are happy to see the snow. But now we've got the cold air coming in and gusty winds blowing across Interstate 90. There's the highway behind me, traffic moving fine right now. In fact, late last night they shut it down for a while around Buffalo, but it has reopened because of whiteout conditions. Let me show you what it looked like this morning right around sunrise, and just listen to the sound of the wind, I-90. I can tell you, just taking my hands out of my gloves for about a minute to shoot that video, it felt like my hands were on fire. That's because of these sub-zero wind chills. This is dangerous weather. Highs today will stay somewhere between about 10 and 12 degrees. That's about 20 to 25 degrees below average here in Erie, Pennsylvania. And look at the snow blowing around in the headlights this morning. That's another issue. Even if it's not snowing, you have to deal with the whiteouts at times, what we sometimes call ground blizzards. And we did get hit by a pretty good band. This is about 8:30 this morning here in Erie, and look at the snow coming down. This is about a half an inch to an inch an hour, so it came down hard. The band moved from north to south and move down towards Meadville and weekend. So the forecast, more snow showers through tonight and tomorrow. We still have that lake effect snow warning up through the overnight hours at least. Locally here, another 3 to 5 inches. There could be some higher amounts. And then it's all about the cold weather for the rest of the week. Highs will stay generally in the teens and lows will be down between about 5 and 10. And remember, sub-zero wind chills. Layer up, protect yourself, stay warm. I'm meteorologist Mike Seidel along Interstate 90 in Erie, Pennsylvania.
Layer up and weather up. That's what we need to do for the eastern two-thirds of the country and certainly around the Great Lakes, because more lake effect snow is coming. We're finding the current lake effect snow machine already kicking in high gear. This, of course, is Lake Superior, Lake Michigan, Huron, Erie, and Ontario. And look at the individual bands that are coming off of each of these lakes right now. This one more prominent, this band coming in right around the Watertown area down to Syracuse. And then we get somewhat of a break right in here for now, but then the next band trying to pick up near the Buffalo area as we're getting the western tip of Lake Ontario and the eastern tip of Lake Erie. A little closer inspection around the Oswego area and Interstate 81. That's where we have somewhat of a heavier band, and this little narrow band right across the central parts of Lake Erie. Now, a little farther north and west, these are the westernmost Great Lakes, and look at this. Now, Lake Michigan really providing some moisture right across the southwestern parts of the lower peninsula of Michigan. So from the Grand Rapids area down to the Indiana border, we could find some locally heavy amounts of snow. Again, this is strictly lake effect. But as we go through time, notice this next little burst. This will be associated with another little weak clipper system that will clip its way across the Great Lakes, and that's going to enhance the lake effect snow. So additional snow is expected. How much, you ask? Well, some pretty impressive amounts, in particular right off of the eastern parts of the lakes on the lee side here, 12 to 18 inches are possible off of Lake Ontario. Jennifer, back to you.
All right, still to come on Weather Center Live, we will explain how the body responds to all this Arctic air, including the important warning signs you need to watch out when you're out in the elements. Plus, there's a live look at Fort Worth. Guess what? It feels like 25 degrees there. Wind gusting up to 35, chance of freezing rain this weekend.
Don't let a severe cold hold you back.
Sir?
Theraflu starts to get to work in your body in just 5 minutes. Theraflu breaks you free from your worst cold and flu symptoms. Theraflu, serious power.
No super slow motion footage of trucks splashing through the mud. No cowboy hats, horses, or hay bales. Just a Ram 3500 that head-to-head can out-tow Ford's F-350 by more than 1.5 tons. Get more facts at ramtrucks.com.
Introducing a PM pain reliever that dares to work all the way until the AM. New Aleve PM, the only one to combine a safe sleep aid plus the 12-hour strength of Aleve.
Today's grocery bags leave a lot to be desired. They dig into your hands when you carry them. They spill open when you're driving. And they're so small, unloading them requires endless trips back and forth to your car. You need a better solution. You need a grab bag. You'll start loving your grab bag the minute you reach the checkout aisle. Because it grabs onto your card and stays open, you can easily fill it after items are scanned. Then when you get to the car, they simply lift out and go right in your trunk. And it gets even better. Grab bags have a broad base and a securing flap, so they sit up nicely in the back of your car and won't spill all over while you're driving home. Plus, they expand to hold several times what a regular shopping bag can hold. Amazing! Imagine being able to grab and go in a single trip. Ever had something heavy rip right out of a plastic bag and smash on the ground? Not with a grab bag. Even this heavy dumbbell is no match for its super sturdy construction, and that's a lot more weight than most people will ever need to carry. Grab bags are made of earth-friendly material that's mold and mildew resistant. They easily wipe clean with just a damp cloth. Even better, they fold flat when you're done, so you can store them in your kitchen or in your car. Every grab bag even has a generous front pocket with plenty of room for wallets, coupons, even cell phones. Use them at the laundromat or even on picnics and trips to the beach. Call now, and through this special TV offer, you'll get two grab bags for just $14.99. They come with a full one-year money-back guarantee. Call or click in the next 5 minutes and get absolutely free shipping and handling. And find out about our incredibly low price on our deluxe insulated grab bag. Use it to keep frozen food from defrosting, or use it to keep hot food ready to eat when you get home. Get two grab bags with free shipping and handling and exclusive pricing on our insulated grab bag for just $14.99. Call now.
Call 1-800-566-6075 to get the grab bag special on this TV offer. But you must call to order or go online to grabbag.com. So call 1-800-566-6075. That's 1-800-566-6075. Call now.
This winter, you've got to watch the Weather Channel mornings.
It's going to have wide-ranging impacts.
Winter storms are too important to cover in just a few minutes.
It's going to be brutal for a lot of people.
Because it's not just about your forecast.
That's why those temperatures stay cold.
Look at this!
Listen to that!
See this winter like never before. Amazing starts here. The Weather Channel mornings.
Currently in our area, 75 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, high 78, winds northwest at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, low 53. Thursday, mostly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, high 67. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Camera.
Oh my God.
Tonight, tomorrow night, every weeknight, Wild Weather at 8 on the Weather Channel.
Well, one more example of trouble in the extreme cold and snow that it has produced. You're looking at some video out of Fort Wayne, Indiana. Earlier this morning, there was a truck that had to be pulled from an icy creek in Fort Wayne, Indiana. You see the video there of the car. And I guess what's left of it, officials believe the pickup slid into the Spiron Creek overnight, and the driver just left her there. He figured it was too cold, and hopefully everybody's safe and sound. Mm-hmm. All right, well, hello, and thanks for watching Weather Center Live. I'm Jennifer Delgado.
And I'm Vivian Brown. Now, the big story this week, dangerously cold temperatures, 20 degrees below average for the eastern half of the country, and that means more than 180 million people under some type of cold weather advisory.
Our coverage of this Arctic chill continues with expert analysis from storm specialist Carl Parker. And Carl, you know, you have the job right now of breaking down these terrible numbers that we're going to be suffering through.
Yeah, it's going to be pretty rough over the next several days. It's gradually going to get better going into next week, and we'll take a look at that in a moment. But in the meantime, you've got this big U-shaped feature in the upper wind pattern. This is the big dip in the jet stream, and concordant with that is the huge plunge in very cold temperatures. It's not that the jet stream is driving the cold temperatures, but rather it's concordant with it, and oftentimes we find that this polar jet is roughly the dividing line between the really cold air and warmer and more moderate temperatures. So huge swing in temperatures in the last couple of days here across many areas. And here is the visible satellite picture. And this is part of what is helping this along. Got a lot of snow cover on the ground there in the Midwest and the lakes. And so as that cold air comes right down from Canada, when there is snow, it enables the cold air to stay colder, sort of refrigerates the air, and it reflects sunlight back out to space a lot more effectively. Another thing that we're seeing today, something we were watching yesterday, is the presence of these wave clouds. Look at those beautiful beautiful clouds there in western Virginia as air flows over the Appalachian Mountains just right in here, starts to pick up a little bit of waviness, the air does, and then right along the ridge tops of those waves, that's where we see clouds developing, and that's what ends up producing that really pretty pattern there in western parts of Virginia. So wind chills right now feels like 21 below in Chicago, feels like minus 7 in Pittsburgh, and 9 is the apparent temperature in Oklahoma City. And when we focus in on the upper Midwest, this is where the dangerous wind chills are. So when you get down to minus 30, when you have an apparent temperature of minus 30, it takes about 30 minutes to get frostbite on exposed skin. So obviously you can't be out here for very long at all, and people know this, but you really could be in trouble if you were to, for example, break down. So you've got to make sure that you've got everything you need in your car to be prepared for that possibility. It's only going to be the same thing through tonight, tomorrow morning, as you go to work tomorrow morning in Chicago. Same story. But well, here's what I can tell you about the longer term. Notice the westerly wind that's coming through here. That's going to break down this big ridge in the west, and it's going to help to even out the pattern. So rather than seeing a big swing in the jet stream like that, we're going to see more of a westerly flow, and that will allow temperatures to come up. So in Chicago, we're going to get to near average in the next few days here, but then towards the middle of the month, we'll actually be above average. Jen, Viv, back to you.
All right. Thanks very much, Carl. Well, you know what? This big danger during this bitterly cold weather is the wind chill. And if you're not protected against it, frostbite could set in very quickly.
Now, it's a big worry for parents and school officials because kids are waiting at the bus stop and they are especially vulnerable. Meteorologist Alex Wallace joins us today to break down some of the important warning signs. And we say this all the time, just really make sure you are bundled up.
Yeah, absolutely.
Leave nothing uncovered.
Absolutely, indeed. That is the key out there, layers and covering up that skin, because when we're talking numbers like we're seeing right now, what we'll be dealing with over the coming days, oh, not a fun situation. In fact, check it out right now. These are the wind chills, what it feels like to your body. You combine the temperature and the wind, 20, 30 degrees below zero out there. When you're exposed to that kind of cold, frostbite can set in about a half an hour out there for you. So let's talk a little more about frostbite and exactly what it is. Basically, it's the freezing of your skin and the underlying tissue there of your underneath your skin. Of course, that could lead to some big problems out there. It's all caused by prolonged exposure to very cold temperatures like we are seeing there in the Midwest and we'll see in the rest of the eastern half of the country. So the body's first response when we're dealing with that kind of cold is to protect the vital organs like your heart. So it cuts off circulation to your extremities, things like your fingers, your toes, your ears. That's why they start to feel so cold out there when you get cold. So that exposed skin to the cold, you end up having that blood not flowing to some of those extremities out there, and that is when you get frostbite that can occur. So what you need to look for, the signs, well, cold skin with a bit of a prickly feeling out there for you, as well as numbness, discolored skin, and looking out for clumsiness because the joints and the muscles become quite stiff. So if you do encounter that, or if you see someone that is dealing with these symptoms, you need to get inside and get warm right away. Some of the results of frostbite: blistering, also permanent changes to sensation out there for you, and in severe cases, you can even have amputation. So we're going to be watching areas in the east and even farther south, Jen, because we've got some pretty cold air coming.
Yeah, you know, and the temperatures are going to get even worse tomorrow. We're talking many areas. That's where we're going to see the coldest air in place. Let's start off right now talking about tomorrow's low to give you some advance warning. So maybe you get up a little later in the morning. Louisville, you're going to see temperature of 0 degrees, 5 in Nashville, 11 in Huntsville, 13 in Atlanta. We're talking numbers running 25 degrees below average. And for tomorrow's lows, yes, that's going to be the coldest day. As we jump ahead into Friday, we start to see the temperatures coming up a bit, but still well below where they should be. For Louisville, we break this down for you. 5 a.m., 0 degrees, 0 degrees, 0 degrees, should say 1 degrees at 7 a.m., a big improvement there. By 8 a.m., we'll see that sunshine out, but they're only still going to be looking at a high of only 2. Nashville, for you, you're going to be suffering as well. 5 a.m., waking up to 7 degrees. You're out of the bus stop at 7 a.m., dangerously cold. 8 a.m., 8 degrees. So all of these numbers, as I said, running 25 degrees below average for Bristol, Tennessee, through early Thursday morning at 8 a.m., you're only climbing to 7 degrees. Over to you, Viv.
All right. Well, this cold blast can be big business, especially if you're, say, in the home heating business. The freezing temperatures are putting furnaces to the test, and house calls from the repairman, well, they aren't free. Our own Dave Malkoff explains how you can avoid having to bundle up inside your own home.
Sure, it's beautiful, but remember, it's brutally cold here in the Chicago suburbs. You shouldn't have to wear all this winter gear inside your home. That should be your sanctuary. But that's not the case for tons of people who woke up this morning with an emergency call to the heater repairman.
I'm just calling to let you guys know I'm heading out there.
The phone calls haven't stopped all day. In some cases, this is the first real test for furnaces all over the Midwest. And some aren't burning as blue as they used to.
Oh, yeah, you see the flame down there, too.
Yeah.
Pretty cool.
Despite that, it has been bitter cold in Nick Drouse's home.
It stays warmer around in the hallway area and by the washroom. Okay. But then when you venture over here, a lot with the open windows and everything or sliding doors.
Yeah, you can feel
doors.
A temperature drop right here.
Yeah, it gets a little colder.
Many older homes around here don't have the kind of windows that keep the winter outside, leaving Nick feeling like a snowman here at night.
Sweaters and sweatpants at times.
You're sleeping in sweaters and sweatpants because it's so cold in your bedroom?
Yeah.
Back in the basement, the diagnosis is in.
It looks like the pilot did come on.
Sam Adicio from Topline Heating says that older burner has seen better days. And it's at least $2,000 to swap it out, maybe $5,000 for a high-end model.
You gotta pay the price sometimes, I guess.
It gets cold in Chicago.
Yep. Yes, it does. Very cold.
And maybe this advice falls into the better late than never category, but it's always best to have a little bit of maintenance in the fall than that emergency call right in the middle of a big winter storm. In Chicago, Dave Malkoff, The Weather Channel.
I'm trying to get past this hat.
I know.
Your ear over there,
warm,
he is warm. We'll be right back.
Currently in our area, 75 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, sunshine and clouds mixed, slight chance of a rain shower, high 78. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy. Slight chance of a rain shower. Low 52. Thursday, mostly cloudy. Slight chance of a rain shower. High 67. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Grandpa Bodie. Grandma said you used to be out of control.
Really? I guess I did take some risks. I trained a little bit differently. I was a little too honest sometimes.
The media is useless.
You were out of control.
But not always.
Audi, proud sponsor of the U.S. Ski Team.
I have a cold with terrible chest congestion. I better take something.
Theraflu Severe Cold doesn't treat chest congestion.
Really?
New Alka-Seltzer Plus Day Powder rushes relief to your worst cold symptoms plus chest congestion.
Oh, what a relief it is.
Here, kitty. Here, kitty. Just come snuggles with Mama.
Missing something? Like the BOGO event at Sears Optical. Right now, buy any pair of glasses and get a second pair free. Sears Optical. Don't miss a thing.
Good night, Mama's girl.
Fiber One now makes cookies. Find them in the cookie aisle.
Not all household cleaners are designed to eliminate pet stains and odors, but Nature's Miracle uses bioenzymatic action to safely destroy pet mess. Right now at PetSmart, save up to 20% on select Nature's Miracle dog and cat products.
If you're driving and you can't see clearly for 1 second at 60 miles per hour, you can't see clearly for 88 feet. And a lot can happen in 88 feet. That's why Bosch created the new Icon with ClearMax 365. It's a rubber technology for longer lasting performance, not found on any other wiper blade. Because like you, Bosch cares about what's ahead.
Welcome back. Big news from Beverly Hills. Celebrity plastic surgeon Dr. Andrew Orton has discovered an anti-aging breakthrough called Fill and Freeze, and he's giving away 1 million bottles free.
I've spent nearly 30 years looking for an effective instant breakthrough to reduce the appearance of wrinkles that can be applied topically instead of with surgery or invasive medical techniques. And I finally found it with DermExclusive's Fill and Freeze.
Wow, I'm young again. I don't feel like an old lady. The lines are gone.
Oh my God, wow. I can't believe it. It looks really good. It gives you a whole new confidence.
It definitely took 10 years off. If I went to a dermatologist here in the city, I would pay $300, $400 for this.
I know you're wondering what Derm Exclusive can do for you. Well, you don't have to wonder. You can order it right now and try it for yourself absolutely risk-free. And here's how.
Call now during this special direct-to-consumer offer, and you won't pay $120. Today, you can get your own instant results with Fill and Freeze for only $59. But that's not all. Today, we're taking another $20 off, so now you can get this instant wrinkle-removing miracle for the low price of only $39.95. And as part of our 1 million bottle giveaway, Dr. Orton is including a second $60 bottle of Fill and Freeze free. That's nearly $120 of Fill and Freeze for only $39.95. Dr. Orton will even include his micropeel resurfacing pads, intensive repair serum, and collagen lift moisturizer, a $200 value, free. Order now and we'll even upgrade your order to express delivery. That's a $15 value, free. Plus, you even get to try it risk-free for 30 days with our money-back guarantee. But you must call to order. Call 1-800-730-7432. That's 1-800-730-7432. Order now.
Well, you know, it's something pet owners never want to see, their dog trapped in the frigid water barking for help.
Yeah, absolutely. But as WTHR's Janine Runovich explains, a panic owner can make things even more dangerous for rescue workers. Listen here.
After 20 minutes in icy waters, frozen and fearful.
He had his feet up on the ice shelf, keeping his head above the water.
This dog got out of danger, saved by the Swiftwater Rescue Team in Shelby County.
And then once I got there, I broke the ice and grabbed him and got pulled back to shore.
It's a scenario these firefighters see too often in winter.
This time of year, seconds make a big difference.
And it's prompted a safety warning, because what you don't see in this video, the dog's owner, who'd been rescued minutes earlier by another member of the team.
En route, dispatch advised us that there was now a person in the water that had tried to self-rescue the dog.
Had she got hypothermic and where she couldn't get out of the water, then more than likely, you know, we probably would have lost the dog to get her and possibly even lost her.
In cold waters, the human body just can't go unprotected for more than just a minute to 2 minutes most.
This is actually the second time in 3 days the water rescue team has been activated for someone who'd gone into frigid water to get their pet. Sunday and Monday, they searched the Flat Rock River for a man looking for his lost dog who'd overturned his canoe.
We just kind of made it a rule that now if we get a call for a pet in the water that's fallen through the ice, that we go ahead and start, because we know eventually that person is going to go out after their pet.
You put that out in front of you and then just pull yourself and it pulls the whole sled.
The team's training and equipment is designed to save lives, human and animal.
This worked exactly the way it was supposed to work.
But rescuers say people need to let the pros handle dangerous waters.
Okay.
They'll make the rescue, just like they brought this pup to safety.
Pull your flak on your blue.
All right, so let's talk more about the cold air, because you want to make sure that you protect your plants, your vegetation, and your pets, even overnight tonight, because the air will remain very, very cold. Look at today now. Highs not getting above zero in the Minneapolis area, barely getting up to zero in Chicago. And look at the 20s from Boston to New York, even down to Philadelphia. Atlanta barely in the 30s today, but even colder tomorrow. Check it out. Your forecast high tomorrow, at Atlanta, only 33 degrees. So just a smidget or a digit, literally, above freezing. Only 13, the forecast high tomorrow in Chicago and the same in Minneapolis. But guess what? That's just the temperature. The winds will still be a factor. So those wind chills will remain quite brutal across the northern tier. Maybe some additional snow tomorrow with a little clipper system swinging through. And this will add to the lake effect snows in those typical lake effect snow belt areas with some heavier amounts. Okay, here is a look at the last day of the week. Pretty dry for most of the nation, but the very cold air definitely covers the eastern two-thirds of the country. But down here along the Gulf Coast on Friday into Saturday, we'll be watching this region very, very closely. Now we have the green and the pink on the map. The green is indicating rain, but the pink, that's where we could be dealing with some freezing rain and some icy conditions, and it'll spread across northeastern Oklahoma into northern Arkansas, even the southern parts of Missouri on Sunday. And then Monday, the area of pink kind of develops right here, but then all snow to the north of this. We think it'll be an all rain event as you head a little farther south, but a chilly rain. Look at you, Atlanta. Your forecast high on Monday, only about 52 degrees with rain. And here's a look at the forecast for Tuesday as we watch yet another system coming back into the picture. The cold air will still be in place, so more icy conditions expected across parts of Texas and Oklahoma come Tuesday of next week. We'll be here, of course, following the forecast for you.
She inspires you. No question about that. But your erectile dysfunction? That could be a question of blood flow. Cialis Tadalafil for daily use helps you be ready anytime the moment's right. You can be more confident in your ability to be ready. And the same Cialis is the only daily ED tablet approved to treat ED and symptoms of BPH, like needing to go frequently or urgently. Tell your doctor about all your medical conditions and medicines, and ask if your heart is healthy enough for sex. Do not take Cialis if you take nitrates for chest pain, as it may cause an unsafe drop in blood pressure. Do not drink alcohol in excess. Side effects may include headache, upset stomach, delayed backache, or muscle ache. To avoid long-term injury, get medical help right away for an erection lasting more than 4 hours. If you have any sudden decrease or loss in hearing or vision, or any allergic reactions like rash, hives, swelling of the lips, tongue, or throat, or difficulty breathing or swallowing, stop taking Cialis and get medical help right away. Ask your doctor about Cialis for daily use and a free 30-tablet trial.
Currently in our area, 75 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, sunshine and clouds mixed, slight chance of a rain shower, high 78. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, low 52. Thursday, mostly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, high 67. Here's our 7-day outlook.
A hot offer for heartburn sufferers. Now try Zantac free at ZantacOffers.com. Hurry, it's free this week only. No pill relieves heartburn faster. Get Zantac free at ZantacOffers.com.
These lights alert you to potential trouble. So do these. See farther, wider, better. Upgrade to Silver Star Ultra headlights from Sylvania.
Hey, guess what day it is?
Hump day!
Hump day! It's hump day!
Yeah. Hey, Mike!
Mike!
Hey,
Mike!
Guess what day it is?
Mike.
Hey, Camel! Hey. Guess what day it is.
It's not even Wednesday.
Let it go, Phil.
If you're a camel, you put up with this all the time. It's what you do. If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to Geico. It's what you do.
Okay.
Attention accident victims.
If you or a loved one has been injured in any kind of accident, you may be eligible for substantial compensation. Don't wait to file your claim. Time is limited. Call now and let a local experienced attorney fight to get you money for your injuries.
If you have been injured in an accident, time is limited to file a claim, so act now. The call and consultation are free.
Call 1-800-307-9899.
Attention accident victims.
If you or a loved one has been injured in any kind of accident, you may be eligible for substantial compensation. Don't wait to file your claim. Time is limited. Call now and let a local experienced attorney fight to get you money for your injuries.
If you have been injured in an accident, time is limited to file a claim, so act now.
Think you have the fastest internet? Think again.
This is Xfinity. This is your current internet provider.
Which do you think is going to download faster?
I'm going to go with what I know.
Ready?
Yes.
Download.
Well,
Xfinity is way faster.
That's not even fair.
And we're done. I'm going to go.
I may have to switch to Xfinity.
Get even more of the speed you need with Xfinity Internet from Comcast. Upgrade to get speeds up to 50 megabits per second for just $10 more a month for 12 months. See for yourself. Call or go online today.
Got bugs that are bugging you? Pest control isn't a joke. It's not funny when your family is afraid of rodents and roaches. And you definitely won't be laughing if you find termites or bed bugs. For pests in your home, you want serious experts. You want Ambassador Pest Management. Residential, commercial, and equine environments are safest with Ambassador Pest Management. Call today for a quote or show us your current bill and see the savings. After all, a peaceful home starts with a pest-free home.
855-713-8687. Experience the best in guided travel.
Ride on the most treacherous highway in the world to experience the high risk of heavy rescue. Highway Through Hell, Sundays at 10 on the Weather Channel.
A live look at Buffalo, New York. Now, the city and surrounding areas got hit hard by lake effect snows back in November. Today, highs in the single digits and some snow showers are in the forecast. Another lake effect event happening as we speak, but it looks like Buffalo will dodge pretty much the worst of it.
Storm specialist Carl Parker is in the lab with your winter weather update. And Carl, we're still talking about some big time snow for some parts out there.
Yeah, we are, Jen. We're going to see quite a bit of snow in the lee of the lakes over the next couple of days, and we'll get into that forecast in a moment. First, I want to have a little bit of fun with the visible satellite picture, and we're getting some really beautiful images. And this is a look at Lake Michigan, and you've got this cold, dry air, clear air coming across Wisconsin and then getting to the lake. Once it gets to the lake, then it picks up moisture and instability because of the relative warmth of the lake and the water that's right over top of that warm water, or the air that's right over the top of that warm water. And we start seeing the development of clouds right in there and lake effect snow showers. Now, it's not something that happens only over the lakes. And take a look at this. We'll drive farther eastward and over into the northeast. And here, too, you see these bands of clouds that are coming out and into the ocean. That is ocean effect snow that we are now seeing offshore. And in fact, when we take a look at the radar picture, there are the snow showers right there developing, and some of them actually affecting parts of southeastern Massachusetts. Just a couple of snow showers around the Cape there into Martha's Vineyard as well as into Nantucket. We're not looking for much in the way of accumulation there. All right, farther west, here is a look at the lakes. Now, this is last night, midnight to 4 a.m. That's the period that we're looking at. At that time, we had a west-southwesterly flow, tremendous lake effect band coming off of Lake Ontario and into western New York. Watertown picking up 2 feet of snow with that band. But right at this time, there was strong north to northwest winds just off to the north there, getting ready to come in along with the front. So now we're going to step forward
forward, and we're going to look at 4 a.m. going until now. Watch what happened to that band right there as the winds switched around and the front came through. The band migrated bodily down through New York and down into Pennsylvania, and we are still seeing a vestige of that now showing up in central and eastern Pennsylvania. So right in here, coming across parts of central PA, lower Susquehanna Valley, as well as into northern Jersey, that is actually what is left of that band that was coming across Lake Ontario and into western New York State, and we're going to get a little bit of snow there in some of the major metros next couple of hours, so could be some heavier squalls from time to time. Also now seeing lake effect driving down into northeast parts of Ohio. It's mostly going to be lighter. We got 7-8 inches in northwestern PA with that flow, and then you've got the band that we talked about earlier, the bands we talked about earlier coming off of Lake Michigan. A number of stations actually reporting moderate snow there in northern Indiana, and then more lake effect snow in the UP as well. Here's the model forecast. So there's that north-northwest flow. Then we're going to watch a clipper come in. That'll be going into Thursday, and that clipper will bring us a broad area of light snow across the lakes late Thursday, and then behind that, another round of lake effect snow is going to set up. So we're going to get lake enhanced and lake effect snow next several days. So through Friday, several inches there in western Michigan, as well as into western New York and northern parts of Pennsylvania. Now, outside of that, when we're talking about winter weather, the next area to watch is going to be the southern plains. And what we've got here Saturday afternoon is the sub-freezing air right there, and then the moisture riding up and over top of that right there, depicted by the grayish color. That could mean frozen and freezing precipitation in Texas initially, then coming up into the mid-south going into Sunday, then perhaps moving up towards the Ohio Valley and the Appalachians on Monday, though I will tell you that the models have been really all over the place about this. But right now we've got a wintry mix in there on Friday, hill country and westward, and that area expands going into Saturday. Jen Viv, back to you.
All right, still to come on Weather Center Live, the latest on a dangerous Arctic blast blanketing the country.
Take a look at the current temperature. It's very cold, and certainly when you factor in the winds, it is brutal. Right now it's 31 degrees below zero at International Falls. Now let me tell you, this is dangerous. You don't want to be outside. If your exposed skin is out, then you have problems.
Currently in our area, 75 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, sunshine and clouds mixed. Slight chance of a rain shower. High 78. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy. Slight chance of a rain shower. Low 52. Thursday, mostly cloudy. Slight chance of a rain shower. High 67. Here's our 7-day outlook.
There, it is dangerous. Arctic air is dominating two-thirds of the country. That means more than 185 million people will feel it. If you're not in it, you know somebody who's going to be shivering.
Oh, let me tell you. Plus, the snow is piling up. The lake effect machine is cranking, and we're forecasting more than a foot of snow in some spots. Hello, and thank you so much for joining us for Weather Center Live. I'm Vivian Brown.
And I'm Jennifer Delgado. The cold air is forcing officials in several states to close schools and get this open emergency shelters, rightfully so, for those people who don't have protection. Well, let's take a look at the temperatures people woke up to this morning. Lows, this is really low. Minus one in Chicago, minus nine in Minneapolis, nine in St. Louis, and five in Buffalo. We're not even talking wind chill. It feels much colder than those numbers.
Oh, it does, because when you factor in the winds, this is really literally what it feels like, to the exposed skin. 28 below at International Falls. Look at Des Moines, Iowa, 27 below, but 30 below in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. So please do not expose your skin. Cover up from head to toe if you have to be out and about.
Well, better wind chills mean this. Look at this. This is a dad here who deserves an award because his child is bundled up just the right way. It's got a blanket on, and you're seeing people walking through the Windy City, also called the Windy and Cold City. We want to make sure everybody is exposed and bundled up. The lady right there, I think you could use a scarf, gloves, and hats. Mm-hmm. And also bundled up was meteorologist Mike Bettis.
Yeah, he's covering this Arctic blast for us today from Chicago.
Here in Chicago, it is our third straight day with temperatures below zero, and it may only get colder from here. Obviously, in these kind of conditions, you have to bundle up as best you can. All the folks that are out here along Michigan Avenue in Chicago doing their best to cover up the head, the toes, the hands, because it's just a matter of truly minutes before frostbite can set in, and you don't want to be caught off guard in these kind of conditions. It's not just us, though. It's also that furry member of the family. A couple of things to worry about with your pets in these kind of conditions is that dehydration can set in. If you have an outdoor pet, you'd like to bring them in this kind of weather, but if they've got a dog bowl that's outside, it can freeze over. They can't get a drink of water, so dehydration can be an issue. Also, just truly, if they're cold outside, especially short-haired animals, or short-haired dogs don't have the protection that a lot hairier dogs might have. And also, on the surface, on the sidewalk where it's been treated with some ice melt, can be very difficult for dogs to walk in. We caught up with some pet owners and talked about their concerns in these kind of conditions.
It's an English lab, right? For him, it's like the best weather he can dream about.
He's cold. So we're ready to go back in. This is the longest we've ever been out in this weather.
How long?
Some of the chemicals that we do use on sidewalks to melt that ice can be very harsh on our animals, and the paws of our dogs especially can crack them, can irritate them. And so a lot of pet owners that we've seen in Chicago use the little paw booties, and this will protect their paws from really getting irritated from those chemicals. Or you can use a lanolin solution and just wipe it on their paws before you take them out. Obviously, it's man and beast against this weather. Mother Nature kind of giving us the cold shoulder here in the Midwest. One more day to go of the really cold stuff tomorrow morning here in Chicago, looking for double digits below zero. That's the very latest here from the Windy City. I'm meteorologist Mike Bettis.
All right, the cold shoulder for sure. In fact, we talk about 185 million of us under some type of cold weather alert. Take a look anywhere from the Midwest into the Northeast all the way down to the Gulf Coast. We're talking about wind chills, very, very brutal all across the eastern two-thirds of the country. So really some dangerous conditions right now, and even overnight tonight and tomorrow morning will be very brutal as well. So let's send it over to the lab. That's where we find storm specialist Carl Parker with more details on this Arctic chill.
Hey Viv, as is usually the case, it's not going to change very quickly. It's going to be really cold for the rest of the week, getting a little bit better going into next week. And let's begin with a look at the infrared satellite picture. And you see the big dip in the jet stream coming down through the eastern part of the country, concordant with that cold air that's coming down. And another thing that you can see here on this type of satellite picture is the cold itself. So what this satellite does is it detects the cold cloud tops and depicts those in white and gray and blue and green and then yellow and orange. So we're seeing the cloud right in here. We're seeing cloud right in here. But because the ground is so cold, we're actually seeing the ground itself in the whitish bluish colors there across the Midwest and into Canada. That's just a depiction of how incredibly cold the temperatures are at the surface, as cold as cloud tops typically are and that are way up in the atmosphere. Wind chills right now, minus 19 in Chicago, minus 9 Kansas City, feels like 2 in Nashville. The most dangerous of wind chills are across the upper Midwest and Western Lakes. Right now, minus 31 in Rochester and minus 30 in Duluth. Now, when we look at the wind chill chart, and by the way, the wind chills are going to be around minus 30 in Chicago tomorrow morning. Right in here, when you get to minus 30, we're going to be at about minus 5 with a wind of 20 to 25 miles per hour. Notice this blue area. That's where frost frostbite occurs in 30 minutes or less. So it really is dangerous, and make sure you are prepared. Make sure, for example, that you've got plenty of stuff in your car in case you happen to break down tomorrow. And it's not just in the upper Midwest. It's going to be significantly colder across a lot of the Southeast. Only 4 tomorrow morning in Nashville. That's minus 24 as compared to average. And many locations may actually see new record lows. We'll get down to about 0 goose egg there in Jackson, 13 Wallops Island, and 20 in Pensacola. So here's the big dip that we talked about right there. Got a big ridge across the west, but then in the Pacific Ocean, we are seeing more of a westerly flow. And what that will do is we'll break down that ridge, and it's going to break down this big dip that we have seen for so long. So we'll get another little wave of cold, but eventually going into next week, we see more of a westerly flow, and we start to, ladies, we start to see some moderation in temperature. Back to you.
All right, that's what we want to hear. Thanks very much, Carl. Well, we continue to bring you the latest information on this dangerously Arctic blast affecting 185 million of us.
That's right. Stay warm. And it's cold enough to freeze an egg? Yeah, that's what's happening in Chicago. We'll have more. Stay with us.
It's out there, waiting on your steps, your sidewalk, your driveway. It laughs at rock salt. It's ice. It fears only heat. Introducing new driveway heat from Prestone. Each concentrated pellet heats up like a furnace to melt up to 4 times more ice than rock salt with no residue. Put your driveway in the Prestone zone with new driveway heat and kiss your ice goodbye.
Look for Prestone driveway heat at these local retailers.
No chest-beating monologues about engine size, horsepower, or performance. No anthemic soundtracks to stir the soul. Just a Ram heavy duty that can carry more weight than any other heavy duty truck. Get more facts at ramtrucks.com.
Think fixing your windshield is a big hassle? Not with SafeLight. This family needed their windshield replaced, but their daughter's heart was set on going to the zoo. So we said, if you need SafeLight to come to the zoo, we'll come to the zoo.
Oh yeah, we can fix that.
Only SafeLight can fix your windshield anywhere in the U.S. with our exclusive mobile glass shops and our one-of-a-kind TruSeal technology for a reliable bond.
Thanks so much.
Service that fits your schedule. Hey. That's another SafeLight advantage.
SafeLight repair, SafeLight replace.
This winter, you've got to watch the Weather Channel mornings.
It's going to have wide-ranging impact.
Winter storms are too important to cover in just a few minutes.
It's going to be brutal for a lot of people.
Because it's not just about your forecast.
That's why those temperatures stay cold.
Look at this!
Listen to that!
See this winter like never before. Amazing starts here. The Weather Channel mornings.
Currently in our area, 75 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, sunshine and clouds mixed, slight chance of a rain shower, high 78. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, low 52. Thursday, mostly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, high 67. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Tonight, tomorrow night, every weeknight, wild weather at 8 on the Weather Channel.
Heartburn.
Did someone say burn? Try Alka-Seltzer Relief Chews. They work just as fast and are proven to taste better than Tums Smoothies Assorted Fruit.
Mmm, amazing.
Yeah, I get that a lot.
Alka-Seltzer Heartburn Relief Chews. Enjoy the relief.
Hot, hot. When it comes to losing weight, everyone has a number. But if you want to get your performance back and feel great, Do what I did. One call and I lost it all. 22 pounds gone.
Lose weight fast with Nutrisystem's Fast 5 Plus Kit. Lose 5 pounds in your first week, plus 1 inch off your waist or your money back, guaranteed.
Nutrisystem has everything you need to feel better, look better, and perform better at any age, faster than ever before.
I haven't felt this good in years. Thank you, Nutrisystem. I lost 8 pounds in the first week.
Order your 28-day Nutrisystem plan right now, including Fast 5 Plus. Get 1 week of meals, plus 1 week of energizing shakes and Craving Crusher shakes, free. New food selections, new expert guides. Call now and lock in 2014 prices, and shipping is free.
Whether your number's 10 or 50, make the right call. Nutrisystem.
Call 877-398-SIZE now and lose your first 5 pounds fast.
Well, it is bitterly cold out there, and it's not going anywhere. In fact, across parts of the South, it's going to get worse, especially by tomorrow. So let's talk about this cold air that's invading the South. As I show you, hard freeze warnings in place. Look at this, from areas like Texas all the way over towards Florida. Yes, Florida. You think you're immune to the cold? You are not. As we show you, these alerts go through Thursday a.m. Wind chill advisory out there. Now, this goes through Thursday, but it doesn't mean it's not going to stay cold, because we're looking at temperatures not rebounding until sometime late next week. Temperature right now, 15 degrees in Louisville, 39 degrees in Atlanta, 25 in Memphis. All of this cold air you see to the north spilling down towards the south. At the same time, we're adding in the strong winds, making it feel much colder than the actual temperature. Tomorrow, bitterly cold out there. 13 degrees in Atlanta, 0 degrees in Louisville. Temperatures running 25 degrees below average across some of these parts. It's going to be as far south as Panama City, as well as into New Orleans. Tomorrow morning, you're going to wake up to 25 degrees. I hope you got some coats down there in the Big Easy, some nice and thick ones. Friday, notice those temperatures start to rebound, but still running about 12 to 15 degrees below average. Now, tomorrow morning, we want to talk about the city, and the farthest south city is going to be waking up to single digits, and that happens to be Highland Lake. They're going to wake up to 9 degrees, and that is an area located about 30 miles to the north of Birmingham. Birmingham for you, 12 degrees. Montgomery, Alabama, Thursday, record low 15 degrees. We are forecasting 16, so we're going to get very close to that record. We hope we don't break it, but there is a very good chance at that. Louisville, your average temperature should be 25 degrees. Thursday a.m., no, this is not a typo, 3 degrees. You warm them to 21, that still is pretty warm, right? But then you drop down to 11 for the morning low on Saturday a.m., and then by Tuesday, you finally get back to the freezing mark. Yeah, you shouldn't be that cold. For Atlanta, your average low, 34 degrees. Thursday a.m., 13 degrees for you, 20 degrees on Saturday. And then notice by Tuesday into Wednesday, we're going to be looking at temperatures in the mid-40s. So that's going to be quite a warm spell in comparison. New Orleans, your average 45 degrees. Thursday, 25. And then on Friday, 35. So 10 below. And then we see the return to the 50s by Monday a.m. And those temperatures, as I said, we might not see really any relief coming until the end of next week. Vivian, that's right. A long time.
That is a long time to wait, I'll tell you what. With this Arctic blast gripping most of the country, we wanted to know just how you're dealing with the cold and just how cold it is in your neighborhood. And we posted the question on our Weather Channel Facebook page and got hundreds of answers, like this one from Allison, who says, it's 3 degrees in West Fargo, North Dakota, with wind chill advisories for 40 to 50 below. First winter in North Dakota, and maybe my last, she says. And take a look at how Bob Heyman from Montauk, New York is battling the cold. Now he's in his hot tub, and this is how you do it. I don't blame you. Montauk, you'll be down to some 8 degrees overnight tonight. And Brad Wilson says it's 14 degrees out and windy to boot, cold enough to make me think about moving south. I'll tell you what, even today, if you move south, you have to go way down to Florida. Take a look at Sunny Isles, not too far from Miami. Temperatures right now in the 70s. We're forecasting highs in the upper 70s, almost 80 degrees. And this is only one of a few spots that you can go to escape the cold today and tomorrow. But look at the forecast, because it will be a little chillier tomorrow, even in Miami. And actually, that's cold for Miami standards. The afternoon high, not getting out of the 60s, but at least here the temperatures will rebound very quickly as on Friday back up to 78. And look at Sunday's forecast, 80 degrees.
Thank God Sam Champion has a house down there. I can just go stay with him.
You can just go stay with
him. We're coming. All right. Well, still to come on Weather Center Live, our Mike Saddell reports from Erie on another round of lake effect snow.
All right. Plus, your full winter weather update will let you know where the heaviest snow will fall in the coming days.
Saving and smiling. That's how I start the year. With tons of stuff on rollback, clearance, and more at Walmart. And that really puts a smile on my face.
Thousands of items on rollback and clearance, in-store and online.
You owned your car for 4 years. You named it Brad. You loved Brad. And then you totaled him. You two had been through everything together. Two boyfriends, three jobs. You're like, nothing can replace Brad. Then Liberty Mutual calls, and you break into your happy dance.
If you sign up for Better Car Replacement, we'll pay for a car that's a model year newer with 15,000 fewer miles than your old one. See car insurance in a whole new light. Liberty Mutual Insurance.
Fiber One now makes cookies. Find them in the cookie aisle.
Not all household cleaners are designed to eliminate pet stains and odors, but Nature's Miracle uses bioenzymatic action to safely destroy pet mess. Right now at PetSmart, save up to 20% on select Nature's Miracle dog and cat products.
Stop by your neighborhood Ace and we'll help you get organized. 18-gallon totes, $3.99 after $1 instant savings.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
What makes it an SUV is what you can get into it. What makes it an NX is what you can get out of it. Introducing the first ever Lexus NX Turbo and Hybrid. Once you go beyond utility, there's no going back.
This winter, you've got to watch the Weather Channel mornings.
It's going to have wide-ranging impacts.
Winter storms are too important to cover in just a few minutes.
It's going to be brutal for a lot of people.
Because it's not just about your forecast.
That's why those temperatures stay cold.
Look at this.
I'm Randy White, Hall of Fame football player, and I'm a PC user. PCmatic sends me emails about the maintenance completed to keep my family's computers running great. Every week, I get emails like these, and it's reassuring that PCmatic is working behind the scenes to keep my family's computers running like new. PCmatic smashed the record books for virus detection in the latest virus bulletin wrap test. It's comforting that my family's protected by the absolute best security money can buy. But I love a good deal. And PCmatic is incredible at only $50 for 5 computers for 1 year. PCmatic is backed by a full 30-day money-back guarantee. I love this country. And PCmatic is made and supported right here in the USA. Take it from me, Randy White, another PC user. Go to PCmatic.com. That's PCmatic.com.
300-8335. 1-800-300-8335.
The wildest weather ever caught on camera.
Oh my God.
Tonight, tomorrow night, every weeknight, Wild Weather at 8 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 76 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, sunshine and clouds mixed. Slight chance of a rain shower. High 78. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy. Slight chance of a rain shower. Low 52. Thursday, mostly cloudy. Slight chance of a rain shower. High 67. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Well, listen to that. The winds adding to the misery as heavy snow poured over Erie, Pennsylvania earlier today.
Well, many schools in the area either closed or delayed opening for at least 2 hours due to the lake effect snow machine and the bitter cold.
Now, more people headed to shelters in Erie as temperatures tumbled and snow swirled around. You saw the video there.
Our own Mike Seidel was in it all, in the wind, the snow, and the brutal cold near Interstate 90 earlier today.
First it was the snow, lake effect snow, and now it's the bitter cold coming into western Pennsylvania, northeast Ohio, and upstate New York. This is what they've plowed here in this Shell Station parking lot, but this time last year they'd already had 6.5 feet of snow. Right now we're sitting at 42 and change, that's right at average, so the plow operators, after really raking in the cash last year, are happy to see the snow. But now we've got the cold air coming in and gusty winds blowing across Interstate 90. There's the highway behind me, traffic moving fine right now. In fact, late last night they shut it down for a while around Buffalo, but it has reopened because of whiteout conditions. Let me show you what it looked like this morning right around sunrise, and just listen to the sound of the wind, I-90. I can tell you, just taking my hands out of my gloves for about a minute to shoot that video, it felt like my hands were on fire. That's because of these sub-zero wind chills. This is dangerous weather. Highs today will stay somewhere between about 10 and 12 degrees. That's about 20 to 25 degrees below average here in Erie, Pennsylvania. And look at the snow blowing around in the headlights this morning. That's another issue. Even if it's not snowing, you have to deal with the whiteouts at times, what we sometimes call ground blizzards. And we did get hit by a pretty good band. This is about 8:30 this morning here in Erie, and look at the snow coming down. This is about a half an inch to an inch an hour, so it came down hard. The band moved from north to south and moved down towards Meadville and weakened. So the forecast, more snow showers through tonight and tomorrow. We still have that lake effect snow warning up through the overnight hours at least. Locally here, another 3 to 5 inches. There could be some higher amounts. And then it's all about the cold weather for the rest of the week. Highs will stay generally in the teens and lows will be down between about 5 and 10. And remember, sub-zero wind chills. Layer up, protect yourself, stay warm. I'm meteorologist Mike Seidel along Interstate 90 in Erie, Pennsylvania.
All right, thanks, Mike. Well, more lake effect snows is expected as we progress deeper into the week. In fact, here's a look at the current lake effect snows. You can see the individual bands coming off of all five of the lakes. As we zoom in a little bit closer, you can see in western New York, but even in the upstate area around Watertown, as you head southward towards Syracuse on Interstate 81, that's where we have a band of persistent snow. And then this little narrow band coming right across Lake Erie, some light snow here, mainly falling just to the west of the city of Erie there in Pennsylvania. Cleveland, you've had some on and off light snow so far today as well. But notice here, this band, pretty normal or persistent, right off of the eastern southern tip of Lake Michigan into the southwestern parts of the lower peninsula of Michigan.